it again focuses on the relationship between self and God. And then when you look at the third component, sober self-assessment, again, that focuses on the relationship between self and God. So the first three pillars is about getting myself right with God. And then when we start talking about serving in love, now we've moved to the relationship between self and who? Others. Amen. Because the only way that you effectively serve God is you got to be willing to serve others. That's what Jesus taught over in Matthew chapter 25, if my memory serves me correct. He says that when the king returns, he's going to ask this question. When I was hungry, did you feed me? When I was sick, did you come and visit me? When I was in prison, did you come see about me? When I was thirsty, did you give me anything to drink? When I was naked, did you clothe me? Because inasmuch as you have done it unto the least of these, guess what? As you serve others, you serve God. And so that next relationship about serving in love has to do with a relationship between self and others. And then that last pillar, supernaturally responding to evil with good. What relationship does that speak towards? Self and who? Self and others. Amen. Self and others. And so we see, as we look at this Romans 12 disciple relationship model, that it speaks to both the vertical relationship, our relationship between ourselves and God, but then it also speaks to that horizontal relationship, our relationship with self and our fellow man. And if we strive to walk in Romans 12, God will bless our lives and we will bless God. Amen. All right. Thank you for your time and your attention. I hope that as we move through this book, that you really got some things out of it, that you can take it and digest it and begin to implement it in your own Christian walk. Was anybody besides me helped by going through this study? Amen. Well, praise God. Thank you so much. Some of you have been so faithful and dutiful and coming as much as you've been able to come, and really want to thank you for your participation. Amen. Do we have any announcements that we need to make? Yes, Brother Merville Johnson. Amen. We have some dynamic singers coming. I know that. You know, anytime Sister Cornice Wells is on the program, that's almost worth the price of admission by itself. But we have some great artists who are coming to lift their talents to the glory of our God and for a worthy cause. And certainly we want to come out and support. Make sure that you let your friends and neighbors and family know, so as Brother Johnson pointed out, we can fill the house. Amen. In honor of our brother, Dr. Raymond Spencer. All right, let's go ahead and we can pull out a Baptist dollar or two, and Brother Hackett will be happy to receive it. So if you have a couple of dollars in your wallet, your purse, if you can pull that out, and we'll give and we'll say a word of prayer and we'll be on our way. And I believe the rain has stopped outside, so streets ought to be a little safer going home. All right, let's bow for a brief word of prayer. Father, once again, it is ours to say thank you. Thank you for allowing us to gather in this place, giving us the privilege once again of worshiping you. Thank you, Father, for your word that continues to challenge us to look at ourselves. We just pray, Father, that you would enable us and empower us by your divine Holy Spirit to walk in the truth of your word, not only to be hearers of your word, to be doers also. Help us, Father, to live so that our light would so shine, that others might see our good works, your good works in us, and give your name glory, honor, and praise. Father, we just pray that you would give us traveling grace, that all things would be well when we return home. We just thank you for your many blessings in our lives. It's in Christ's name we pray and we give thanks. Amen. God bless you.